Nearly 4 years ago, Iran Air placed a hefty order with Boeing. The airline wanted 80 planes, including 15 Boeing 777-9s. That order would have helped Iran Air double its current fleet size. The order was worth around $9.5 billion and would have helped support 100,000 jobs. But then, of course, things happened to sink the deal. Relations between the United States and Iranian governments had long been tense. That made things difficult for a US-based aircraft manufacturer. Perhaps it also helps explain why the vast bulk of Iran Air's existing fleet consists of Airbus aircraft. In 2015, United States President Barack Obama lifted a decade of sanctions preventing the sale or export of civilian passenger aircraft to Iran. At the time, Iran Air had a fleet of over 200 planes, but that fleet was aging and needed modernizing. Because of the sanctions, getting spare parts to repair existing aircraft was a problem, and around 40% of the fleet sat grounded. Earlier this year, the fleet size was down to about 40 aircraft. State-owned Iran Air wasted little time placing big orders with both Airbus and Boeing. In December 2016, Boeing announced an order from Iran Air for 80 aircraft that included 50 737 MAX 8s, 15 777-300ERs, and 15 777-9s. At the time, Boeing was careful to explain that the order complied with the terms of the United States government license issued to sell to Iran. Replacing Obama, President Donald Trump was considerably tougher on Iran, pulling the US out of the Iranian nuclear deal and reimposing sanctions. That meant the sales license Boeing had to sell to Iran was void. While the first aircraft from the order was set to be delivered in 2018, Boeing now only had a 90-day window in which to do so. Those 90 days weren't long enough, and no Boeing aircraft went to Iran Air. By May 2018, the order was dead in the water. Boeing's then CEO, Dennis Muilenburg, was reported telling Wall Street analysts that, "We have no Iranian deliveries that are scheduled." In addition to the lost Iran Air order, Iran's Asaman Airlines had seized the window of opportunity to order 30 Boeing 737 MAXs. Iran Air's order with Airbus also collapsed in the wake of President Trump's sanctions decision. Airbus was set to deliver 118 aircraft to Iran Air, including 12 A380s. But unlike Boeing, Airbus did manage to get 3 planes to Iran, including one A321 and 2 leased A330s. While Boeing doesn't officially have much control over what the United States government does, it probably does suffer from being a United States-based business, at least from an Iranian viewpoint. Iran's relationship with Europe has always been less tense, and that benefits Airbus. If and when sanctions are lifted again, perhaps Iran Air will try its luck again, but it may well turn to Airbus first. Do you think Iran Air would order from Boeing again if sanctions were to be lifted? Let us know your thoughts in the comments. Did you know that we publish over 175 stories every single week on simpleflying.com? Be sure to check the link in the description for more great stories just like this. Thanks for watching, and be sure to like and subscribe before you go.